हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द यूनिट 4 रीडिंग सी ए ट्रिब्यूट। दिस इज ए रेस्पेक्ट गिवन टू द एक्ट्रेस सावित्री। द इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री हैज कंप्लीटेड 100 इयर्स इन द ईयर 2013। इट इज ए फिटिंग ट्रिब्यूट टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ सिनेमा टू रिकलेक्ट आवर फेवरेट फिल्म्स, प्रोड्यूसर्स, डायरेक्टर्स, एक्टर्स एंड म्यूजिक एंड आर्ट डायरेक्टर्स। As the Indian film industry has completed 100 years in the year 2013, so they are conducting a fitting tribute to the world of cinema. Why? To recollect what are the favorite films, who are the producers, directors, actors, music and art directors. In that, Telugu audience are proud of many great producers, directors and artists. So we, the Telugu audience, are very much proud as we have the great producers, directors and well artists. Savitri is one such prestigious artist. So among all, we are going to take the heroine. She is none other than Savitri. She is one such prestigious artist. Ever since she was 8, she evinced interest in learning dance. When she was of 8 years, she had an interest. What kind of interest? Invented interest means she showed interest in learning dance. Later, she associated herself with the theater. She connected with the theater organization. So finally, she formed a theater organization as well. She had little difficulty in entering the film field. When Savitri was 12, she was offered a role in the film Agni Pariksha, but was finally dropped as she looked too young for the role. Entering into the film industry is not easy. So Savitri also taken much pain in entering. It is very difficult to her in entering the field. But when she was of 12 years, she was offered a role in the film Agni Pariksha as a heroine, but finally she was dropped because she looked very young. Too young refers to very heroine role is given to another lady. She was given a song sequence Ranante Rane Ranu in Patala Bhairavi. Savitri's part in it was brief, but the effect of her performance was considerable. Her expressions were beautiful. A lot of filmmakers recognized a potential artist in her. But as she was finally dropped in the Agni Pariksha, so her roles were not stopped. She was given a song sequence in the film Patala Bhairavi, and the song name is Ranante Rane Ranu. In that song, she has shown her expressions very effectively. Her performance was considerable. So all the filmmakers recognize she is going to become a great artist in her career. As a result, she was elevated to the role of a heroine by the noted director L.V. Prasad in the film Samsaram 1950. So as a result, as the directors have observed, the filmmakers observed her expressions in brief in the song, so she was elevated to the role of a heroine. She was given a chance by the director L.V. Prasad in the film Samsaram, which was taken in the year 1950. On the set, she was nervous because she was too young during that age. So she was very nervous. She had to repeat many takes and this proved a setback for her. So when we feel frightened, we cannot go forward. Always we'll be coming back. We feel tense, we'll forget everything. In the same manner, Savitri also felt very nervous because many people will be there when they are going to play such kind of roles. Repeat many takes, this proved a setback, a failure for her. So, the role was given to someone else and she was given a small role of less import. Finally, the heroine role was given to someone as she was unable to do, but they did not take away this lady. She was given a small role of less importance in the film Samsaram. In the film Devadasu 1953, one of the best picturization of Sarat Chandra Chatterjee's novel Devadas. So the next film after 1950, in 1953, the role The heroine role was given to her in the film Devadas. This was a picturization of Sarat Chandra Chatterjee's novel Devadas. Parvati comes alive in Savitri. Now she is acting as a Parvati, the young Parvati with curly hair. How is the description here? Very important. Curly hair, a lock of hair straying to her forehead. Lock of hair means a small piece of hair near to the forehead. See in the picture, you will be observing this. The large round blackberry eyes looking out from an innocent face left an indelible imprint in the minds of all cine lovers. And her eyes were described as large round blackberry eyes. Looking from an innocent, when we look at the lady, she is very innocent, means not well versed with the ways of the world, left the indelible imprint, impossible to remove. Once if you observe, never forget in our lives. So indelible imprint in the minds of all cine lovers. From then people liked that heroine very much. Portrayed Devadas love and the role of a rich man's wife marvelously. Savitri left her mark in this evergreen Telugu classic. So she portrayed means she represented the Devadas love and she is acting a role of a rich man's wife marvelously, excellently. So Savitri left her mark in this evergreen Telugu classic. Savitri established her credentials with Ardangi 1955. So trustworthiness, her role in Ardangi 1955, she gave an exceptionally brilliant performance as a woman forced to marry a mentally retarded person, ANR. And her performance is very excellent in the film. And she played a role as if she was forced to marry a mentally retarded person. And who is that man? ANR. She nurses him back to health. She brings back the man to proper health. She also teaches a lesson to her in-laws who conspire against her husband. And she is also ready to teach the lesson. She taught a lesson to in-law who plan secretly to harm that man. So that film became a great hit during those days, the Ardangi film. Savitri captured the audience with her charm and magnificent acting. So how Savitri became a great heroine? Because she captured, she caught the audience with her charm, with her beauty, grace and magnificent, extremely impressive eyes. Her mischievous look, it captivates anyone. The look of fake anger provokes. The look filled with real anger pierces the heart. The look of passion while waiting for her lover, the pain-filled look when her love fails, the confident look that seems ready to face any situation. All these myriad emotions are hidden in her eyes. The dimensions are endless and pages can be filled to describe the magic spell of her eyes. So how are her looks? It is very mischievous and it is going to captivate, it draw attention, anyone. See the way she looks, the fake anger provokes, had a particular effect. And the look filled with real anger pierces, penetrates the heart. The look of passion, her while waiting for the lover, the pain-filled look when her love fails, the confident look that seems ready to face any situation. These are all extremely large number of emotions are hidden in her eyes. The dimensions are endless, the aspects are endless, we cannot see, and pages can be filled to describe the magic spell, the having a special power of her eyes. Savitri's amazing talent was in full form in Miss Amma. So in the film Miss Amma, we can see her amazing talent. It's so surprising talent. A hit comedy that established Savitri's place firmly as a star. It is a great hit which made the lady as a star. Mary in the film comes into an agreement with a Hindu youth, NTR, to pretend as a couple in order to get a job in a school. In this film, how did she act? She acted as a Christian, Mary, in the film. We're coming to an agreement with a Hindu person, NTR, to pretend as a couple. Why they acted as a couple? To get a job in a school. Mary was Christian to the core, whereas Rao was a tolerant Hindu. What results in is a 3-hour pure comedy for the audience. In the Misama, we'll find that these two are of different religion. They need a job. So to get a job, they should be a couple. So they acted. Finally, the result of the film is 3 hours pure comedy. Enjoyed. All the audience enjoyed very much. Savitri was adored for the matchless ease in expressions. She loved very much. Having no equal in her expressions with anyone, Meena Kumari, the heroine of Hindi film, said, "When I watch Savitri's acting, I usually get doubts about my own acting." The great heroine in Hindi films, Meena Kumari, she said that, "When I watch the Savitri acting, I usually get doubt about my own acting. Her strikingly expressive eyes and her superb sense of timing made her one of the greatest actresses." So one thing is expressive eyes, second one time. So when we are making the time perfection, automatically we'll have a good life. So her superb sense of timing and second expressive eyes made her one of the greatest actress. Amitabh Bachchan felt Savitri was one of the first actress with unbelievable spontaneity, a quality of happening naturally. So she plays a role. Director says to play like this, like that, but the actor had to play that role, feel themselves. So her unbelievable spontaneity. She is the only one of the first actress who can show the talent. Maya Bazaar is another film that brought fame to Savitri. She played the role of Sasreka, recollecting the 16 Annas Telugu lass clad in parikini in the song Alli Billi Ammaiki, reminds us of the rich Telugu culture of earlier years. And we have seen the Maya Bazaar film in the previous. That film also brought a fame to Savitri because she played a role of Sasreka, recollecting the 16 Annas Telugu lass clad. Mean that she is the giving an expression which means a perfect Telugu girl. In the song, Alli Billi Ammaiki song, it reminds our Telugu culture, how the Telugu culture is so rich of earlier years. In the final part of the film, Savitri plays the role of Maya, not real Sasreka Ghatotkacha in disguise. She walks in a masculine manner, imitating the legendary S.V. Rangarao, acting as Ghatotkacha in the film to perfection. Now coming to the final part of the film in Maya Bazaar, she played a role, Maya Sasreka. Like Ghatotkacha in disguise, she walked in a masculine manner, imitating the role, S.V. Rangarao's role, acting as Ghatotkacha in the film to perfection. The theatre rocks with laughter when Lakshmana Kumara, who acted as Ralangi, is teased by Maya Sasreka. So Lakshman Kumara is teased by Maya Sasreka. She switches from the feminine to the masculine in the twinkling of an eye, and needless to say, a female artist displaying masculine demon qualities with a club in hand has no parallel. So she changes, switches means changes from the feminine to the masculine in twinkling of an eye, and a female artist display showing that demon qualities with a club, with a stick in a hand has no parallel. Savitri gets totally involved in whatever role she plays. So why she became such a great actress? Because she is going to involve in the role. We'll see in this film, Chivaraku Migiledi is one such film. She played the role of a nurse in a psychiatric ward. In a particular scene, the nurse has a nervous breakdown and cries uncontrollably. The shot was over, cut, the director said. But Savitri, who played the role, could not stop crying. Everyone in the set had to run to her and pacify her. The film became a milestone in her career. So in the film Chivaraku Migiledi, she played a role. She has to play a role of a nurse in a psychiatric ward. But in that scene, she became nervous, breakdown, disappointed in her role and cried a lot uncontrollably. Now the scene was completed. When the scene was ended, they'll come to a normal position. But Savitri was still playing the role because she is unable to stop crying. The reason is that she involved. So everyone in the set run near to her and pacify her. This film became a milestone in her career. Important in the career. Savitri was awarded the title Mahanati, the supreme artist. She also received the presidential award for her performance in Chivaraku Migledi, the magnum opus of Savitri. She was the recipient of Kalaimani and Nadigeyar Tilakam from Tamil industry. Savitri had nearly 300 films to her credit. Her career was nearly 30 years long. She was equally admired by Telugu and Tamil film lovers. She also acted in a few Kannada and Hindi films. She had a lion's share of films when she was at the zenith of her career. Her passion for films was so strong that she directed and produced a few films in spite of her certain adversities. And the award she received, the honors, Mahanati. She also received presidential award for Chivaraku Migledi, the magnum opus of Savitri. Even in Tamil film industry, she was a recipient of Kalaimani as well as Nadigeyar Tilakam. In her career of 30 years long, she had nearly 300 films to her credit. In Telugu and Tamil film lovers admire her equally. She also acted in few Kannada and Hindi films. So she had a lion's share is an idiom which says major portion when she was peak of her career. So her passion for films was very strong. Even she directed and produced, though she had faced many difficulties in her life, but her passion made her so strong to direct and produce few films. Savitri was a humane artist. So she is a very kind-hearted lady. She was generous to the people who were in need. So when anyone comes and asks that they were in need, immediately she is ready to help them. Once she donated all the jewelry she was wearing to the Prime Minister's fund, her rise as a star was like a meteor. She left the world in 1981, leaving an envied and unsurpassed legacy behind her. Once she donated all the jewelry, why? To the Prime Minister's fund. So her rise as a star was like a meteor, which is called shooting star. She left the world in 1981, where she left an envied, we felt an unsurpassed, the sad situation of legacy inheritance behind her. Savitri is no more, but she is among us with her unforgettable roles. Her versatility lives on and on and on. Though Savitri was no more, but people remember her. Why? Because she played such an unforgettable role. Her talent to do many things lives on. In tribute to her, the director and producer Dasan Narayan Rao said, many artists are forgotten soon after the death, but it is not so with Savitri. She will be remembered as long as celluloid lives on. So as long as the film industry, movies lives on, so she has a great remembrance in the film industry. All her films would amount to an album of life due to their range of themes. They encompass human lives and passion in their full diversity. What is cinema? Is it a fiction or a reality? Many people say many things, but Savitri gave a different definition. She said that cinema is life, life is eternal. So is cinema because life runs through it, and Savitri is eternal since she gave that life to cinema. So all her films were amount to an album of life. They encompass, means they surround human life and passion in full varieties. Actually, what is called cinema? Is it a fiction or reality? Many people say many things, but Savitri gave a different definition. She said that cinema is life, life is eternal. So is cinema because life runs through it, and Savitri is eternal since she gave the life to cinema. So such a great actress. She is our prestigious artist. This is about the Savitri. Here are the glossary meanings. Once you go through this glossary. Thank you. Have a nice day.